Welcome back. In this video, I'll be going over coordination monitor and review in Revit 2022. So we'll start off by loading a model that is going to be the architectural discipline, and then we will go through the scenario of working with between an architect and a structural engineer on that. So it's possible that the engineer is receiving the architect's model and linking it in, or it's the other way around. In this case, the engineer, structural engineer, is linking in the architectural model at origin to origin, and then proceeding into identifying which elements in the architect's model need to be copied and monitored. We'll look first at the elevation view of the building, and we'll see that there is a discrepancy between the architect's model and the engineer's project template. You see here different levels. Levels are basically not coinciding except for the ground floor or level one. So the engineer will proceed into deleting all the levels that exist in their template and simply keeping one level, that is the level one or ground floor. Now, if the views are needed, you can simply recreate the views using the view menu floor plan command later on, or structural floor. Then we will go to the collaborate menu, copy monitor command, use the link. Click on the link, and of course the copy monitor menu will show up. They have different options such as levels, grids, columns, walls, and floors. And these are the only elements that can be copied and monitored from the other discipline. So the engineer proceeds into copying multiple levels in this view, and then click on finish twice. Finish on the option bar and finish on the menu. Once that is there, then you can see that there is a signal, there's a symbol there that shows up in the middle of the screen on along the column line F that and symbolizes that these items have been monitored, namely the levels, to be specific. We have to go to a different view in order to copy monitor other elements, such as the floor plan. So in the floor plan view, the engineer selects the entire building and copy monitors, in this case, the structural grids, the floors, and the columns. So making sure that we use the filter for that to verify that the selection only contains columns, floors, and grids. Once everything is copied and monitored, then we can proceed into saving the project. And you know, meanwhile, back on the forum, when architect is will continue to work, they're not going to stop working. It's because they have given the engineer a copy of their model. So next morning, architect is working on their model, right? And they make a change, such as moving the structural grid by 3 feet to the right and then deleting a structural column. So saving that, so if we did our work correctly, then we take off the architect's hat, put on the structural engineer hat. Next morning, they receive a message that this needs coordination review. Okay, so I'm going to hide the elevation tag and then zoom to fit and then proceed into running the coordination review. But I'm going to simply pan over the plan view so I can leave some empty space on the left-hand side for the dialog box to open. I'll use the coordination review this time, not the copy monitor. Select the link and then a list of coordination issues shows up in the report. The best thing to do at this point is to actually look at what you see and then export the report, create a report and save it as a record of what happened on that day before you take action on it. So we can see clearly, because we know we have moved the structural grid, we know that this is the, we have a duplicate grid in there, but in most cases you don't know, because they're gonna tell you what they did. They're just gonna send it to the copy of the model. So the first action is to look at the grid has moved and then take action on it or add a comment. The action in this case would be postpone, reject, accept, or modify, right? So modifying the grid means that you would move your grid to match their grid. Okay? Once that happens, then you have been coordinated. So all the issues related to the grid goes away, except for the column has been deleted. So what kind of action do you want to take on that? As an engineer, you could say, okay, I want to reject that because it's a structural problem, and add a comment such as, this is not working for me, this costs too much money, it creates structural issues, it means that we have to redesign this area for cantilever, or whatever structural issues that can come up, and then wait for the architect to respond. Maybe call up for a meeting and discuss the issue, and then after the meeting you can also create a report of the responses. Send that to the architect and say, can I have a meeting with you to discuss these issues, please? Right? And then after that, you could decide if you agree, if you're going to go ahead and delete the element, you can delete it at this point. Hit the apply button twice, and then all the issues have been coordinated at this point. Okay, so you decided that the column will be deleted because that's the client request or something. And you just, money is no object, you can deal with it later. So that's the coordination review, hope it was useful. Thank you for watching, take care.